Okay, so let's see what these unit balls look like. Let's start by focusing on the 2 norm. So the set where the 2 norm is equal to 1 is of course equivalent to the set where chi 0 squared plus chi 1 squared is equal to 1. And that's something that almost surely you have plotted before. That's the unit circle, the circle with radius 1 centered at 0. So that particular set is this set right here. All right. So now let's look at the set of all vectors with one norm equal to 1. In other words, all points distance 1 by the, well, all points such that the absolute value of the first coordinate plus this absolute value of the second coordinate is equal to 1. And let's think this through. Well, it's pretty obvious that all of these points are going to lie between minus 1 and 1 for the chi 0 component, and between minus 1 and 1 for chi 1. So it's going to be somewhere there. What are some points that are obviously on this set? Well, if chi 0 is equal to 1, then chi 1 has to be 0. So this point has to be on there. And if chi 0 is equal to 0, then chi 1 can be either 1 or minus 1. And of course, by the same reasoning, we see that the point minus 1, 0 is also going to be in that set. Right? Now, absolute value, always a little bit difficult to deal with. Well, if we know that chi 0 and chi 1 are positive, in other words, if we ask the question what points in this quadrant are in this set, then this becomes the set chi 0 plus chi 1 is equal to 1, which we recognize as a line. And that line has to go through these two points, so therefore we know that in this quadrant, all of those points are in the set. Okay. Similarly, you can reason through the fact that all of these points are in the set, all of these points are in the set, and all of those points in the set, and as a matter of fact, only those points are in the set. So now we have a picture of all points to which vectors with one norm equal to 1 point. Right? All right, so let's do the last one. That one is a little bit harder. Okay, let's come up with some points that would be on there. Let's see. 1, 0 would be in that set. Zero, 1 would be in that set. Minus 1, 0 would be in that set. Zero minus one would be in that set. So far, so good. But 1, 1 is also in that set. So is minus 1, 1. So is minus 1, -1. So is 1, -1. And if you kind of reason through it that way, you find out that all points such that chi 0 is equal to 1 and chi 1 is between minus 1 and 1 are on that are in the set. And so are all of these points and these points and these points. So there is the unit ball for the infinity norm.